It is indeed a pleasure for me to welcome you to this graduation exercise. This is the 34th commencement in the tradition of Bryan Adams High School. This is a special class for me because this class is my first class. I don't think that I could have been blessed with a better school, a better class. I think maybe that's why God sent sunshine on this day, because we've had a couple of weeks of rain. Seniors, I think someone's looking down on you, and I'm thankful that you have a beautiful day for your graduation. This class has stood strong this year, united together. We have a lot of turmoil across this land, but this group, the leaders of Bryan Adams High School, the student body, have stood together all year long. They're sensitive, they're understanding, and they have a global sense of community, and I thank them for that. They leave behind a great legacy of tradition, high standards, and moral values at Bryan Adams High School. I have never known a class that has carried through a senior year as this class has. I appreciate you leaving that legacy for those who follow, and it's a great thing. It is with those same high standards that this class has asked its audience to carry out with respect and dignity and honor the traditions of Bryan Adams High School and your applause. They ask you to refer to the back of your program and look at the section that says dignity and honor. Because we're here today for our formal exercise, we'll have an opportunity to celebrate and hug and swell inside with pride after this is over. But the class of 92 asks that you be with us in honor and dignity, and make sure that the graduation exercise is the very best that they can have for all. Thank you in advance for assisting us in that honor. I appreciate it, and I know the class of 1992 appreciates that. It is with great pride also that I look at the people on this stage that are here as mentors, as teachers, as community members, and I would like to introduce those folks that are here. From the Dallas Independent School Board of Education, our board member, a member of our community, Mr. Dan Peavy. And if you would, hold your applause and let me go through all of these, because I have several. Teresa Parker, Dean of Instruction, Bryan Adams High School. Dr. Don Platt, Assistant Principal, Bryan Adams High School. Mr. Charles Kennedy, Assistant Principal of Bryan Adams High School. On my immediate left, some folks have done an outstanding job historically at Bryan Adams, have served you well, and make sure that you have everything you need to graduate today, the counselors of Bryan Adams High School. On my immediate left, Tina Hurler, Ms. Beverly Geese, Ms. Patricia Parrish, and Mr. Barry Stevens. There are some other folks here today that make this graduation especially a great graduation. I would like at this time to recognize Mr. Harris with the orchestra. He's done an outstanding job along with him. Mr. Ruby Ray, an outstanding choir of Dallas, Texas, and I appreciate both of them. I would also like at this time to ask that the faculty and staff of Bryan Adams High School, who are here to support this graduating class as they always have in the last 4 years, would you please stand? Thank you very much. Another group that's worked very closely with this class to ensure that they've had a wonderful senior year, that they've done an outstanding job providing activities for these students. Senior class sponsor, Ms. Pam Otto, Ms. Barbara Carroll, Mr. Bill Flagg, Ms. Carol Little, Ms. Melinda Potts, Mr. Bo Taylor, to Jose Perez. Thank you. Also, I would like to recognize the group that's been leaders for this class that are here today, sitting on the front row. Officers of the senior class, Daniel Carey, class president, Jennifer Fowler, that class vice president, Darren Wood, secretary, and Isaac Morgan, treasurer of the senior class. There's one other group that's here today that I don't think any of you could do without, that supported you and financed you and are here today with a lump in their throat and a swell of pride, and that is your parents. And at this time, I would like for this class to show appreciation for their parents' support by giving them a big round of applause. Thank you. At this time, would you welcome to the microphone the senior class president, Mr. Daniel Perry. Goals for themselves and the rest of of our school. I'd like for all members of the National Honor Society to please stand. Thank you very much. Parents and friends, I think if you counted all those folks with honors and honors from the National Honor Society, you can see that the students at Bryan Adams High School are very well equipped academically. I thank those teachers and those students for their efforts. The next two awards are for students that have gone beyond 98% of this class in achievement. They work very hard, probably starting junior high school or middle school. They maintain averages every year that were exceptional. And at this time, I would like to recognize a young man who is a salutatorian for the class of 92. He's been up here several times, but this time I want to make an introduction. This young man is a member of the DICA team, president of the senior class, member of the National Honor Society. He's a member of the student council, member of the Spanish club, Latin club, a member of the president's council, member of the Montpelier trial team, led in football and baseball, he's a member of Young Life, and for the past 4 years he's been all-city academic team for the Dallas Independent School District. At this time, I would like to congratulate and award a medal to Mr. Daniel Perry, salutatorian for Bryan Adams High School.
Yesterday, I was a lowly freshman experiencing my first day of high school. I can remember sitting in class and thinking, okay, only 364 more days and another 3 years when I'm out here. Well, all those days have passed, and now we are truly out of here. But before we go our separate ways, we must take the time to reflect on our high school years. These past 4 years have been good times as well as bad times for all of us. However, as we begin to tackle new obstacles in life, each and every one of us will realize that this has been the best and most carefree time of our lives. How can we ever forget our freshman year? With it came the experience of learning new traditions, as well as the constant harassment that seemed to always accompany that classification. Can you imagine at one time we actually looked up to seniors like ourselves? Yes, that year was quite long. But finally graduated from that title. And after a summer that passed too quickly, we returned to our favorite school as sophisticated sophomores. Along with the title of sophomore, to some of us and the opportunity to drive. Many of us out here can be found exploring Dallas on Friday and Saturday nights. Some of us even be found doing this on weeknights. Finally, however, another year came to an end. And our junior year found many of us beginning to accept our role as upperclassmen and making a difference in such varsity activities as band, bells, and cheerleading. Our junior year also marked the beginning of college applications and entrance exams such as the dreaded SAT. The class of 92 was definitely on the rise. After a solid summer of jobs, fun, and sun, we returned to the beloved alma mater as mighty seniors. This definitely has been the most enjoyable and interesting year of all. The status is very comfortable, and teachers seem to be much more kind as we begin to realize how important they are to us. This year certainly brought me new experiences, such as a lockout, a new principal, a new dean of instruction, a new head football coach, and a varsity and athletic director. Yes, this year's been quite original. Class of 92 has done much to be remembered, and we've definitely stood strong during many changes we have seen at Bryan Adams in our 4 years. We all have different opinions concerning them, but no matter what our opinions are, we will always remember bright spots for our 4 years, such as games, dances, and weekends at the lake park. There's no doubt in my mind that we will always hold close to our hearts the image of Bryan Adams as a great institution, and the fact that we are part of that institution. In closing, I would like to wish each and every one of you a successful and happy life. Thank you.
We will bestow this highest honor, the highest academic honor that can be awarded for high school graduates in the state of Texas. The young man who's receiving this award is president of the National Honor Society, student council vice president, member of the Key Club, member of Dallas Challenge Youth Advisory Board, member of the Latin Club, member of the show choir, band, most valuable swimmer, most valuable wrestler, led in football, baseball, cross country, member of the President's Council, recognized as Dale Hanson Scholar Athlete, and the latest award that he was awarded by the school board pertains to the FEMA All-State Scholar. At this time, would you welcome to the microphone the student that maintained a 97.64 average, Aaron Timothy
Be aware of wonder. Remember the little seed in the styrofoam cup. the roots go down, and the plant goes up. And nobody really knows how or why. But we are all like that. Goldfish and hamsters, and white mice, and even the little seed in the styrofoam cup. They all die. So do we. As we walk out from our sheltered places and into the bright sunlight, keep in mind those simple guidelines, and success is sure to follow. Always accept nothing less but the best from yourselves and from those with whom you acquaint yourself. Stepping forward today, I challenge you to remember the words of Tennyson. I would follow knowledge like a sinking star beyond the utmost bound of human thought. I am a part of all that I have met, yet all experience is just an earthquake where through shines that unshrouded world whose horizon moves forward forever and forever when I move toward it. Come, my friends, it is not too late to seek a better world. Though much is already done, much still remains. If we are but strong in will to strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield. Good luck.
The next speaker is someone that's not a stranger to any of us. He is now as much a tradition in a Bryan Adams neighborhood as Bryan Adams. He's been an educator. He supports education. He supports Bryan Adams High School, and he supports the district's efforts to educate all students. He has a son in Bryan Adams High School. He lives in the Bryan Adams community, and he's a friend of mine. He supports us in all that we do, educationally, and at this time I would like to welcome him to bring you the message, Mr. Carver Dan Peake.
Thank you very much. I noticed as I was looking in the program that my job today is commencement message. I remember 4 or 5 years ago when I first started doing this, as I was elected to the board, they kept giving us these documents, made 9 pages, and as I rambled and rambled on at commencement exercises, I kept telling them that these speeches they were preparing for us were, if anything, a tad too long, babies started crying, people started leaving, and so this year they took my advice and they gave me one sheet, so you're not in for at least a very long message. I don't know whether you call it a message, maybe it'll be a short bit of advice. I welcome being here today. I would like to bring greetings to the platform guests, to a very relaxed area director who's probably sitting up there somewhere thinking, oh, I didn't have to do this, this year in our commitment, to your very dedicated staff, to your very dedicated principal, Larry Smith, to other platform guests, friends and parents and teachers, and of course the graduating class of Bryan Adams High School for 1992. I would like to first say that this is obviously a very special, significant day for me, or on this day 27 years ago, I had the privilege that you're having today of receiving my diploma. That's 1965, for those of you who are counting to figure out how old I am. Receiving my diploma in 1965 from what I consider still today the finest high school in the Allison Penn School District. And I want to compliment the neighborhood, the parents and the teachers and obviously the students for still making this a matter of pride for me as I represent this district and as I represent you and your constituents. Presenting the seniors of Bryan Adams High School with your diploma is obviously one of the more pleasurable duties that I have as a member of the school board. Those other duties you read about in the paper, I'm sure, those are part of the game, part of the politics that is unfortunately involved in trying to educate the youth of today, trying to bring about the best possible learning conditions that we can for children. But the things that engulf today, the things that bring about what happens today, I'm very proud to be able to be here to share with you. You have worked very hard for this day, and I'm honored to hand you your diploma for your hard work. I feel particularly privileged to carry out this responsibility because in handing you this certificate of graduation from high school, I know I'm handing you a key to the future. A key that can open the door, and how far that door is open will obviously depend on you. A key that can open the door to greater opportunities for you and for your life and for your family. As you reach out to receive your diploma, I hope you will join me in remembering all who have reached out to you over the years. This has been mentioned earlier from several speeches, and I'm happy to see kids appreciate their parents. All who have reached out to you over these years, and all who have helped and supported you, all those without whom this day may not have become a reality. I'm thinking of parents, of grandparents, of aunts, of uncles, brothers and sisters, special friends, neighbors, and guardians. I'm thinking of 13 years worth of teachers and counselors and bus drivers, lunch lines, cafeteria workers, crossing guards, and all the people that have gone about to make your education what it was for you. I'm thinking of individuals who have fought and risked for the freedoms and the educational opportunities that bring us together today. The same freedoms and educational opportunities that will keep us together as a nation today and as a people tomorrow. With appreciation for them and the pride that the work that you have accomplished, I look forward to presenting you your diploma. I think if nothing else I say, I could echo what your auditorium said. One thing you can always remember to do is clean up your own mess. Because if you do, you will leave this world better than you found it. May the road rise to meet you, and may the sun be always at your back, and may God hold each of you in the palm of his hand.
You heard cherish the moment. Well, this is that moment. Mr. P, it is my privilege to present to you the 1992 graduating class of Bryan Adams High School. I certify that they have met every particular and peculiar requirement of the Board of Education, the Texas Education Agency, for graduation from the Dallas Texas School District. I further attest that they are duly and truly qualified, worthy, and I proudly vouch for these youngsters. Thank you. Students, would you please come forward as I call your name to get your diploma? And academics.
Ogunse Amiu Isan Akar. Tammy Renee Alford. Alexandra Alonso. Christopher Lee Amen. Kelly Renee Anderson. Ken Mural Anderson. Francivia Diane Andrews. Gina Danielle Andrews. Maria Guadalupe Asensio. Yalia Alex Atta. Rodney Bailey. Sonia Annette Bailey. Paul Nicholas Barber. Lisa Michelle Barker. Cherise and Gwyneth Beasley. Jose Luis Belton. Andrea Starlight Bishop. Keith Allen Blackman. Robert Farrell Brinkley. Luke John Brock. Matthew Mark Brock. Damascus Dewan Brown. Jason Michael Brown. Deanna Renee Bryant. Tina Danielle Bryan. Cheryl K. Burns. Anna Renee Caballero. Michelle Ann Calvo. Kimberly Lynn Cannon. Ann Michelle Carey. Jason Hobart Carter. Timothy Dale Case. Chrissy Lynn Capron. Christopher Michael Chamley. John Paul Carrillo. Brandon Corey Clark. Cecil Bryce Clendenin. Lisa Ann Wallace. Deanna Renee Cuellar. Melinda Christine Dango. Val Dowell.
Chadwick Joseph Dean. Hightower.
Marcy Lynn Hill. Tanisha LaShawn Hill. Justin Holland. Kevin Lynn Poe. Angela K. Cooper. Christina Lee Hughes. Melinda Dawn Hunter. Rosie Gina Jacob. Emily Jean Jez. Cynthia Rochelle Johnson. Field.
John Miller. Rhonda Omega Miller. Robin Lee Milliken. Santos Nina Moreno. Michelle Morgan. Natomi Sonoma Mosquero. Matthew Thomas Moxley. Amy Elise Myers. Lisa Ann Nash. Rachel Regina Navarro. Catherine Shiwe Deeby. Tiffany Renee Neal. Adrian Devon Rubin. Stephen Douglas Sampson. Sydney Cortez Sasser. Marshall Allen Sebastian. Stephen Ray Skinner. Noel Smith. Sean Eric Smith. Tiffany Chate Smith. Tracy Suzanne Smith. Rita Song. Keisha Shante Spain. John Allen Spriggins. Sarah Elizabeth Spurgeon. Brittany Ann Stevens. Thank you.